rather than talk about how to boost your testosterone levels like all the videos on YouTube, let's be real here. If you're over the age of 50, how do you maintain what you had? How do you just prevent the decline, or at least reduce the decline? Because you don't need to be a monster over the age of 50. Come on, that's not what you're after. You're trying to be healthy, you're trying to build muscle, you're trying to look good, you're trying to feel good. So let's maintain the levels that we can. And that's exactly what I'm here to talk about. So hey, I wanna make sure you hit that red subscribe button first, and then hit that little bell icon so you can turn on notifications. That way you know whenever I'm posting a new video. We have videos coming out just about every single day, and they're always educational. They're always full of practical tips and things that you can utilize. So I beg of you, please do hit that button. All right, let's go ahead and dive in. The first one is kind of Mr. Captain Obvious, okay? That is, hit the weights and hit them pretty hard. But before you turn off this video, because this is stuff that you've heard before, I promise I'm gonna get down to some very granular, interesting things as we go. I just have to lead off with this one. Okay, so the journal Sports Medicine in 2010 published an interesting study that highlighted it in just very simple terms. Okay, they took a look at men that were like from the ages 38 to 53. Okay, and they said, okay, go ahead and work out. And they found a single bout of resistance training increased their testosterone quite dramatically. But that wasn't just it. They broke it down, and they broke it down in a way that allows me to give you some tips. So they found that it increased androgen receptor activity. Okay, now androgen receptor activity is where testosterone actually binds, okay, where the actual hormones that make you build muscle and things like that actually bind. Well, they found that these androgen receptors became more active hours after the workout. So if you follow the tips that I'm gonna lay out in this video and you apply them in the hours after a workout, then you can capitalize on the heightened androgen receptor activity. So when you are going into the gym and you're over the age of 50, it's very important that you don't really waste your time on smaller movements if testosterone is your goal. Okay, so what I mean by that is this study found that doing a jump squat increased testosterone 15%, whereas bench press only increased at 7% within the same workout. So larger body parts are going to be the way to go. Now, that being said, you can cycle through your workouts in such a way where you do your large workouts for your large movements first. So you go to the gym and you hit your squats, you hit your big movements, your deadlifts, things like that, things that are comfortable for you but still big moves. Those are gonna increase your testosterone levels. Then you cycle through to your smaller body parts. Now what happens is you have a higher degree of circulating testosterone after you've done those bigger movements, so you get more out of the smaller movements. So let's say this, you go, you squat, you jack up your testosterone levels because you squatted, and then you go and you do some bicep curls, which normally wouldn't induce any much of a testosterone response at all. And because you did the squats first, you have serum testosterone levels that are elevated, so you get more out of your bicep exercise. So you wanna go bigger to smaller. Next up is you're gonna wanna make sure within that that you keep your rest periods short, which is so opposite of what we always hear. We always hear, no, you should recover and then you should lift heavy. That has its place, but if testosterone and hormone optimization is your goal and you're over the age of 50 and you're wanting to live for a long time and focus on that, keep your rest periods short. This study found that 1 minute rests had significant improvements in testosterone versus 3 minute rest periods. So make it quick, hit those big body parts. You should be huffing and puffing. You should be taxing your body. You should be putting yourself through a little bit of a stressor. That's what's gonna help get you the result. Now let's jump over to things that you consume. Okay, so tip number two is gonna be consuming lots of vitamin A, vitamin D, and the mineral zinc. Okay, so the first off, a study that was published in the journal Endocrinology found that subjects that were deficient in vitamin A ended up having testicular atrophy. So if they deprived the subject of vitamin A, basically their testicles would shrink. And this simply had to do with the fact that clearly there is a relationship between the production of testosterone and vitamin A. Okay, now we take it another step further once again, and we look at a study that was published in the Journal of the Frontiers of Endocrinology. Well, this one got pretty interesting because it found that vitamin A played a role in Leydig cell differentiation. Leydig cells are the cells that actually produce testosterone. See, it goes like this. Hypothalamus portion of our brain sends a signal to the pituitary. The pituitary gland sends a signal down to our testes, and our testes ultimately produce testosterone. Well, that's all regulated to some degree by the Leydig cells, and if we can improve differentiation, then those cells can divide, they can do their thing, they can be healthy, and they can produce testosterone. Turns out vitamin A is required for that. Okay, so now we look at vitamin A, but now we jump over to vitamin D, which is also technically a hormone, and vitamin D is very, very critical for testosterone, which we'll talk more about. But vitamin A and vitamin D can come as somewhat of a package deal if you eat liver. Now, I'm not saying that you need to, but I will say it's a bioavailable form of vitamin A, and you get some vitamin D, and you also get some of the other things that you need. You also get the protein, anyhow, get the minerals. We'll talk about that in another story. So a study that was published in the Journal of Hormone and Metabolism Research took a look at 54 men. They had them consume around 3,300 IUs of vitamin D for a year. Okay, and they compared that to a placebo group for a year. Well, they found at the end of this study, no surprise, the vitamin D group had markedly higher levels of testosterone. In fact, they had an increase of about 3.9 nanomoles per liter just in that 1 year period, just by adding vitamin D. Now, additionally, they also had a big increase in bioactive testosterone, but more importantly, they had an increase in free testosterone. The testosterone is actually used, it's not bound to sex hormone binding globulin. This is what we want. We want this testosterone. But why did this work? Why did this happen? There's still a lot of question out there, but one thing that we can link to for sure is that we have vitamin D receptors all over our body. But we have a lot in our hypothalamus, we have a lot in our pituitary, we have a lot in, well, men, in our testes. So once again, if we link back to what I talked about with the hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis, that axis is going to require vitamin D throughout all chains of it. So it tells us that if we are deficient in vitamin D, somewhere along that hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis, we're having a disruption. So we need to get our vitamin D. So bring in the sardines, bring in the fish with the scales, bring in the anchovies, bring in the salmon, and bring in the liver. We should be eating these things. Again, foods that sometimes we are told are not good for our cholesterol or not good for our health. Well, saturated fat, cholesterol, things like that are required for some forms of testosterone production. And vitamin D usually goes along with these, as well as vitamin A. And before I jump into talking about zinc, let me mention that if you get good quality fish and you get good quality meat, you're going to get the vitamin A that you need, you're going to get the vitamin D that you need, and you're going to get the actual profile in its healthy form that you need to support healthy levels of these things in your body. I did go ahead and I put a link down below to ButcherBox. So ButcherBox is a place for you to get grass-fed, grass-finished meat delivered to your doorstep. So yes, if you are looking to boost testosterone, you need to, you know, keep a lot of things in mind. But at the end of the day, eating healthy and eating clean is going to be the best thing you could possibly do. So if you want to save some money and get grass-fed, grass-finished meat delivered right to your doorstep and save some money because you're watching this video, you're going to want to check ButcherBox out down below in the description, okay? So therefore, you're going to get more of the minerals that you need, more of the vitamins that you potentially need. But best of all, it's probably the best tasting steak, in my opinion, the best tasting ground beef, and some really good salmon as well. So again, special pricing for those of you that watch my videos, special link down below, but finish this video out first. Now, bringing it on to zinc. I put zinc, vitamin A, and vitamin D in a category together because I feel like they are the big three. Okay, zinc is super critical. There was a study that was published in the journal Nutrition that took a look at 20 weeks of a mild zinc deficiency. They found just a mild zinc deficiency resulted in a significant reduction in testosterone levels. Well, another arm of this study actually took a look at older men, and they supplemented older men with a little bit of zinc for 6 months. Well, guess what? These older men experienced almost double testosterone levels just after 6 months of adding a simple zinc supplement. What? Why is this? Well, zinc is required for the conversion into testosterone. There's something called androstenedione, and that has to get converted into testosterone. And if that doesn't get converted into testosterone, it's really just a pretty weak hormone. It doesn't really do much. So it kind of amplifies once it gets converted into testosterone. So we need this androstenedione to do its job, otherwise it's weak. Well, the other thing is that low levels of zinc have been associated with higher aromatization of testosterone. That means more testosterone getting converted into estrogen. If we have estrogen, then we have less testosterone, and it turns into this vicious circle because estrogen compounds. And then the more testosterone that we bring in, the more potential for it to convert into estrogen. So we have to keep healthy, and we have to keep all these other things in place. That's where the weight training comes in. That's where the cardio comes in. That's where the sleep comes in, which, speaking of sleep, let's move into the REM sleep. You don't need to be sleeping a ton, but you need to be getting good quality sleep, because it's getting into REM sleep that is important. You see, the other stages of sleep are just a necessary evil to get into REM for a short period of time. Yeah, sure, we need our deep sleep, we need our restorative sleep there, but believe it or not, REM sleep is not the deep sleep, and REM sleep is not a sleep cycle that you're in for that long. But you do need to get yourself there, because those short periods of REM have a big, big, big result when it comes down to testosterone. Take a look at this study that was published in the journal JAMA. Okay, took a look at test subjects that were normally sleeping 8 hours and 55 minutes, and it cut them down to 4 hours and 48 minutes. So from 9 hours to 5 hours. Those lucky suckers getting 9 hours. Who's getting 9 hours these days? Anyway, they were able to cut them down, and they found that when they cut their sleep down that much, they had a huge reduction in testosterone. In fact, just 1 week led to a 10 to 15% reduction in testosterone levels just by cutting their sleep that short. That is really, really scary stuff. The simple fact is that our endocrine system comes to life at night. Okay, growth hormone, testosterone, all these things pump out at night. Yeah, we have different peaks throughout the day, but to have that restorative effect, we need that REM sleep. For whatever reason, it sends a pulse. Okay, this next one is super, super important. And I know way too many men out there who are trying to increase their testosterone levels. So the first thing they do is they just go to the gym and they try to eat more and they eat more of the eggs and they eat more of the beef that I recommend, right? They do. But the most important thing is to drop fat first. Yes, you need to get lean first. Remember, the extra fat that is on your body will convert testosterone into estrogen, and that is going to kill your testosterone production. So if you have fat on your body, you have more sites for estrogen, more sites for aromatization. So when people ask me, well, should I lean out first before I build muscle, or I want to try to build some muscle, and do this first and then I'll lean out. No, lean out first, because the leaner you are, the more benefit you're going to get from your testosterone, because less of it's going to turn into estrogen. I can't overemphasize this enough. Fat will turn testosterone into estrogen easier. Get lean so your estrogen just is out of the equation, and get lean so your testosterone can do its job. That way, the food that you eat, the butcher box meat that I'm talking about, can actually do its job, okay? And the good healthy foods that you're actually trying to take in can actually play a big part. So yes, you might be over 45. Yes, you might be creeping up on 50. But your testosterone levels don't have to suffer if you take the right precautions, if you do the right things. So make sure you're adopting these methods and make sure you're keeping these things in mind, because it's gonna play a big role. And again, once again, I ask that you please do check out ButcherBox, because, well, not only is it gonna save you some money, but it's gonna make food taste better, and it's gonna make it so you can at least get the quality nutrients that you need to help support what you're after. So as always, do keep it locked in here on my channel. I'll see you in the next video.